What's up, you guys? It's Molly. Welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel if you're new. If you're new here, my name is Molly. I'm a freshman at the University of Alabama, and today's video is one that I've been very, very excited to film. I've been kind of planning this video for a few weeks. A lot of you, I have mentioned this in a few of my past vlogs, but a lot of you have been super interested to know kind of my experiences here at Alabama and just like some questions you guys want answered about the school in complete honesty, and I want to be able to be that resource for you guys. So today's video is just my truth, my experiences here, answering your questions, adding some stories in, so it'll be kind of a mix of story time and a Q&A. I'm really excited to film this video for you guys because I have had a lot of ups and downs here at school, and as my first semester is coming to a close, I really just want that chance to share this all with you guys for those who are interested in coming here, but also for those who just are curious about how my experience has been, because I want to be transparent and honest with you guys. So in spirit of this video, I threw on my Alabama sweatshirt, and I have a ton of questions I asked you guys on a few different question stickers on my Instagram, and I asked some of you to ask me questions through private messages. People reached out to me and through YouTube as well, just asking you guys what you wanted to know about my experiences. So I have a ton of questions on my phone that you guys asked me, so I'm really excited to answer them. So without further ado, let's jump right into the video. The first question is, how do you balance studies and Greek life? I honestly feel like it is very easy to balance studies and Greek life. Obviously, it is more dependent on your major. I feel like majors in more of the STEM majors are a little bit, obviously, of a heavier workload. I am a news media major with a psych minor, and so I'm still in the introductory classes. It hasn't gotten too challenging, but a lot of the Greek life here on campus, especially the sororities, I know for sure are very dedicated to their academic. I haven't had any struggles with it. I feel like you only have to put in as much into Greek life as you want, obviously in terms of like paying dues and everything, you have to do all of that, but like in terms of being at the house and stuff like that, but I don't force myself to be if I'm too busy. I love being a part of Pi Phi, and it's the greatest group of girls I've ever met, but sometimes you just have to prioritize that. And so if you are interested in coming here and you're finding yourself when you get here being very heavy on workload and you're in Greek life, just know that there are people in Greek life that can help you in terms of tutoring and stuff, but you can also take your time out of Greek life if you think that would be best and focus on your studies. The next question is, how did you make a routine at school? So this was a thing I touched on in my What I Wish I Knew Before I Came to College video. When I came here, obviously I walked right into recruitment, so I had very early long days, and I woke up, I would eat breakfast, get ready, and that kind of already started making me a routine. Classes only started like 2 or 3 days after rush and after bid day, so I kind of just, in terms of my schedule, like I'd wake up at the same time every day, go to class, kind of break up the time in between classes where and when I would study, stuff like that I think is really important. So that was definitely how I made my routine. What are some things worth bringing to college? What are some things you wish you brought with you? Honestly, I think I came very prepared. On campus here at Alabama, we do have a lot of suite style dorms. I believe there are only 3 or 4 traditional style dorms here. Prez, obviously I have my own closet. So yeah, so you definitely want to come prepared. I brought a good chunk of my winter stuff. So if you are coming here and you're living in Prez, you chances are you can fit all of your stuff in the closet and under your bed, just so you know. Some things I wish I brought with me though, I wish I brought more kind of like sentimental things. If you guys want me to do a like what to bring for your college dorm video or something along those lines, I've done a dorm haul, which I'll link down below for you guys. But if you want me to do like a top things you need for your dorm video, give this video a thumbs up because I will totally do that for you guys. The next question is, how has college affected the relationships of those close to you? I talk to my family every day. I talk to my dog every single day. And I think it's really important when you're going to college to just know that you should talk to your family every day. Chances are they really want to talk to you. It's good for them to be in the loop and for you to just kind of talk to them when you're homesick, make you feel like you're at home a little bit. My close friends, I feel like, is one that is a little bit less consistent. My best friend Anna, I talk to her pretty much every week if I get the chance on the phone, or we just text or whatever. My friend group, we talk occasionally. I kind of talk to all the girls in my friend group as I can, when I'm free, when I think about them, when I'm doing something that reminds me of them. I always try to reach out because I do still obviously care about them and their friendship to me so much. I think it's definitely different, especially if you are going so far from home. Like, no one from my school came to Alabama. I'm gonna be going home in a few short days for Thanksgiving break, and I'm gonna see my friends for the first time since going to college, since saying goodbye to them in August. So I'm really excited to see them. I don't really think any of my relationships have been affected negatively since I've come to college. If you just put in the effort though, I think it'll be good. The next question is, what is it like being so far from home? Was it easy to transition? I feel like going through recruiting recruitment here was definitely a way to really ease the transition because I met a lot of people right away. And before school even started, I was a part of an amazing Greek organization, which I think is huge. And if you're coming here, rushing was the best decision I ever made. I was honestly hesitant prior to coming here, but coming here was a really good decision because Greek life is such a huge part of this campus and a lot goes on through Greek life and you're involved in so many amazing things through your sorority or fraternity. So I would definitely say that helped the transition. Being so far from home is a little bit weird, but it's only a short flight away. It definitely is weird because I feel like if I had chosen a school closer to home, I would have seen my parents far more frequently and my dog far more frequently. Honestly, I'm getting used to it. I love this school and it doesn't really feel like I'm missing home because this has become my home in a part of a way too. It hasn't been too bad, but rushing definitely helped. The next question is it hard being out of state, which kind of goes off of the last question. It can be hard at times, especially when your friends that are all kind of staying close together at home, at school, are all together all the time and you feel a little bit left out, like they're making memories without you. That's just how I felt, I feel like, and toward the beginning, but I love being out of state. I think it's an amazing thing. You meet so many diverse people here at Alabama. I know we have more outstate students than in-state students, and it's just a really great way to meet a bunch of new people. But coming out of state really forced me out of my bubble a little bit, and I learned a lot more about myself, and I got to meet a lot of different people with a lot of different stories, and those are kind of experiences that I don't think I would have gotten staying in state. The next question is, if you couldn't have gone to Alabama, where would you have gone? This is a really good question. To be honest with you, I had a long college admissions process. I have a college admission reaction video and I have a why I chose Alabama video, which you guys can totally check out if you want, which I touched on this topic in both of those. I was always dreaming, believe it or not, to go to the University of North Carolina. I had grown up playing soccer. I love playing soccer. And for a while I thought I'm gonna go play soccer there. That was like the dream of mine. And even though when I stopped playing soccer, I still wanted to go there because it's an amazing school. I did not get into UNC. Out of state is absolutely insane. And I really frankly wasn't expecting to get in. My top choices after I was rejected from UNC were Georgia and Alabama and UT Austin. My second choice was Georgia. So that would be probably where I had gone if I hadn't come here. What would it be like if you were in Greek life and don't like to party a lot? This is where I'm gonna get very, very honest with you guys. I am not a partier. I never have been. I frankly feel like I never will be. So take it from me. I am in Greek life. I go to Alabama and I'm not a huge partier. If you ever feel like you wanna talk to someone about it, I'm more than welcome to talk to you about it because I feel like it's something that more college students struggle with than you might think. And I'm gonna be completely honest about it with you guys just because it's who I am. So don't worry too much about that. There are so many other things involving Greek life than parties. Don't think that is all of it. So many Greek organizations here, all of the Greek organizations here have amazing philanthropies you can get involved in. Just an amazing group of girls. You can go to the house and just hang out with them. It's just a really great way to get involved. So don't rush because you think you have to go to parties because trust me, you don't. The next question is, was it hard to get into the presidential dorm? So my roommate blessed us with the first priority date of picking housing. Thank God for her because I thought I was early when I registered in December for housing and I was toward the end of priority. Prez typically is one that sells, or not sells out, I shouldn't say that word, that fills up before all other dorms just because it is a bigger dorm. You get your own room. It's a suite style dorm. For some reason, everyone wants to live in Prez. I am on the 7th floor. Yes, the myth is true. The rooms on the 7th floor are bigger than the other floors. That is a true rumor. I would say yes, they do fill up pretty quickly. I know 7th floor and 3rd floor tend to go the quickest because biggest rooms and laundry. I think there were still available rooms the second day of registration, but people always move and change, so you could get lucky. But don't stress too much about it because all the dorms here honestly are very, very nice, so don't worry about it too much. Next question is, talk about social life and parties. So I feel like a lot of social life, at least for me here, I can't really speak on anything else because I haven't known anything else, is around Greek life with fraternities, with sororities. A lot of my social life has come through Pi Phi, and I met a lot of people through that, and that's kind of where I spend a lot of my time when I'm not in class or at meetings for different clubs and extracurriculars and stuff like that. But there are a lot of really cool band parties that happen often here on campus at the fraternities with a lot of really cool different people. I know Sean Kingston was at one. A bunch of rappers came. Some country artists came that I've never heard of, but I love country, so Love that. University of Alabama definitely has a great social scene. There's a lot to do though outside Greek life. If you don't want to be in Greek life, totally understand. There definitely are a lot of options. I wouldn't be afraid if you aren't in Greek life though in terms of your social life. I feel like everyone finds their place here. That's the beauty of this campus and this school. So I wouldn't stress too much. The next question is talk about academics. So academics here at UA are great. I mean, I'm in the communication school. The communication school here is one of the top programs in the country. We have a lot of amazing people that are professors here at UA. Particularly in the communication school, that's really the only school I can speak on. I have loved every minute in every class I have been in thus far at UA. This campus is filled with a lot of brilliant people, and I have gotten the privilege to meet so many of them through my sorority, through Capstone Agency. It really is what you make it, and I have had an amazing time, and I feel like I've learned so much in the short time I've been here. The next question is, would you recommend Bama? Yes, I love it here, you guys. Like, it seriously is the most amazing school on the planet. We have pretty much everything you could ever want in a school. Obviously, Greek life really sold me on it when I decided to rush, because I had such a negative image in my mind about rushing, and everything that rush, my experience in Pi Phi has taught me is I just don't listen to the rumors. It is amazing here, you guys. I mean, I have had such an amazing time here in my sorority, a part of Capstone Agency. I've started to pursue what I want to do in life here because of Capstone. It's just a really great place to be. I really hope that if you are considering coming here, if you are considering applying, if you're considering just seeing it, come, because I really think that when you come here, it changes how you feel about it. It really is a great, great place, and I fell in love the moment I toured it last year, almost a year ago. Right now, I was here touring. If you are even remotely curious about this school to come and tour it, you can ask me questions, you can ask other people questions. I feel like everyone on this campus is so like open to sharing how amazing the school is with other people. So I would definitely recommend Alabama. The next question is, I believe you are a news media major. What career are you planning to do? So obviously I touched on this a little bit ago when I was talking about Capstone Agency. So Capstone Agency here on campus, if you are a communications major, marketing, business, if you are interested in PR, advertising, anything kind of related to it, apply to Capstone Agency if you come here and are interested. It is such an amazing group of people. It is a student-run PR and advertising firm here on campus. I am a part of the Capstone Communications team, so I do all the social media for the entire agency, which is really, really cool, and I love it so much. I do want to get into PR, but I also want to integrate writing in that. I would love to do PR or journalism for a fashion company. That would be my goal. My ultimate goal would be to work for Vogue, put it into the universe. That would be my goal. But yeah, I'm kind of just seeing where fate takes me. I do want to focus on fashion though. I also really do love sports, so I would also consider doing something for sports in terms of PR, marketing, journalism, whatever it may be, because I'm kind of trying to tie all that in together. But that's kind of the path I'm heading on right now. The next question is, do you find people who have had a bad Greek life experience? I'm sure there are people that have had one. I have not come in contact with any of those people. I've not talked to any of those people. I don't know any of them. The one thing that I will say to any of you that are asking this or wondering about this question because you're debating rushing, rush is a long week. I will say that. It was a long week and it was a little bit nerve-wracking for me. Go through rush, like see where it takes you. Okay. My camera died. We're back. So as I was saying, I was talking about the question, do you find people who have a bad Greek life experience? To sum it up, because honestly, I don't remember what I was saying 10 minutes ago. There definitely are people, but I feel like I encourage you guys, whether it's a bad rush experience or a bad Greek experience, to push through it, because chances are you will find people that you relate to and that you feel strongly about. Obviously, not everyone is this way, but if you stick with it, I have had a really good experience, and I'm confident a lot of you guys will too if you decide to go through recruitment here. Obviously, if you end up joining a sorority, it isn't meant for you. That is just fate, but I think a lot of the sororities here are really, really great, so I hope you guys all have a really good experience. The last question is, what is advice you'd tell your junior or senior self? I was so stressed in high school, like, I can't even fathom or explain it to you guys, like, how stressed I was in high school about college. Everything happens for a reason. Alabama was not on my radar when I first started my college search, but as I went through it, I fell more and more in love with it here, and I can safely say I made the best decision. Everything happens for a reason, for real. I mean, had I gone to UNC, I might have not even liked it. Like, there are Georgia, there are a lot of things that come into play, and I met the most amazing people here. I've had the best experiences, and it definitely did happen for the better. If you are debating coming here, I'm gonna tell you to do it. I love it here. If you ever feel like you want to reach out to me about anything about the school, I'm more than happy to help. But if you're just a high schooler watching this, wanting to know more about Alabama, but also just nervous about college, just know it all happens for a reason and that you will end up doing great things no matter where you end up. Okay, you guys, that is everything for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you learned a little bit more about the University of Alabama, about my experiences. If you did, give this video a big thumbs up, hit the subscribe button down below. If you want me to do more Alabama related videos, please let me know. Comment any more questions you have down below and I will try to answer them best of my ability, because I know I probably didn't touch on all of your questions in this video, but I tried to touch on most of them. So I really hope you guys enjoyed the video and I will see you guys next time.